Starting off the Christmas month with a new kit sent over by Model Roundup, made by Salvinos JR Models 1/24th scale, early 80s Pontiac LeMans stock car. Why do you ask? Is it just a black and gray car on the hood? Well, this is a choose your own adventure model that I'm going to call it. It is a model that is sent with no decals, just this stock car in the box with all the parts we need to build it. And then from Model Roundup, you can select your own power slide decals to go on and make the car you want. So you save a little bit of money up front. You don't have to have a set of decals that you never want to use of a car you didn't want to build. You can get the blank model and pick out your own decals on modelroundup.com. So let's take a look at all the parts that'll be in your kit when you get it of this new LeMans built by Salvinos. These are the older monogram molds that they will modify to fit their new purpose. We can see the nice chassis there. I just love building these kits, and I'm going to keep building them because there are a billion variations out there through all the generations. We can see that these molds have been around for a while. They still go together so nicely, and all you get is just a little bit of flaky flash that slices off super easy. There's no big issues, and everything still fits beautifully and looks awesome. You can see that we've got some other parts in there because they are other molds like this. We've got the other style hoods. We've got the beautiful trunk detail if you want to cut the trunks open. We got the dashboards, we got our firewall, pedals, wheel backs, roll cage. On this tree here, we've got the nice small block V8. The headers, which are super detailed, I just love the ones in there. We got our front suspension, check out the dual shocks all the way around. Racing steering wheel, oil cooler, differential. Nice gauges. If you just want to do the gauges out of the box, they are beautiful. Exhaust system, television camera. It would make more sense to you if it's like this. It's like the antenna, the lens, battery packs and all that. We got our cylinder head, shock system, belt and pulley, water cooler, fire extinguisher, and more front suspension and links. We'll get to, these are the grill and bumper from the other versions that this kit is molded off of. We've got the racing seat in there. For the LeMans version, we've got the LeMans front end, bumper, spoiler with little rivet detail, and hood. These are new parts by Salvinos. They look awesome. They've even got bracing under the hood. Excellent look at those new parts. We've got the nice wheels. This would normally be with that awesome real metal chrome. Here they're painted white, so you can choose what you want. This is really a craftsman kit. Got our beautiful radiator assembly, valve covers, oil pan, shifter, other spoiler, air cleaner, intake with distributor. Look at our little mini hood pins. Don't forget to get those painted up. Alternator, carburetor, and those awesome, beautiful wheels. We've got the yummy LeMans, Pontiac LeMans body. All ready to go. As far as I know, this is a new mold. So they designed this. This is not a reproduction or a reissue. Excellent lines on there. Looks lovely. Don't forget to remove the extra material, but don't remove the nose. Let's go to the other side of the desk and see what's over there. One, we have one of the headlight bezels fell off the new LeMans headlight parts tree, so we'll just show you that real quick. We've got four solid rubber slick tires. These easily sand down. Do not assemble your wheel and tire package both sides. You'll have an almost impossible time pushing them into the tires on these. Make sure you paint your wheel and your wheel back separately, and then towards the end you can just push them in and they friction fit beautifully every single time. Makes for a trouble-free wheel and tire. We've got glass here from the peeps at Salvinos. Crystal clear, no defects, no warpage, no watch face look to it where it's all distorted. And then the decals I picked out for my build, the JD Stacy, the first 200 mile per hour qualifying car. beautiful power side decals through Model Roundup. I will link to all this stuff in the description as always. Beautiful, and it should be a pretty easy paint job. As far as I know, the entire car is white and the decals make up the rest. I like when they include all that stuff with that pinstriping. They include the gauges if you don't want to paint your gauges. They've got tire decals. There, you can just see them coming through. For the tires, we got metallic look inserts. Yeah, it looks like real metal. We've got hood pin decals if that's what you want to use and fill in your hood. Awesome. So we're all set to go. I'm going to start building mine and I'll be right back. The nostalgia runs deep every single time I get to dig into another stock car kit. This ləˑɑːnz by Salvinos has been falling together. Very little flash to remove to get the original parts, and the body goes together super nice. We'll see that in just a little bit. First, I'll show the parts that the minor assemblies that were going to get painted. The headers were just cleaned up from there, a little bit of flash. Those are going to get painted up on the side. Same color as the drive shaft, so we've got that cut off on its own little tree. When I cut parts off of a tree after painting, I just use a little bit of the spray can, squirt it into a plastic cup, and touched up with a brush, and you never notice. Now, the wheels, if you go to and look at the power side decals and you Google JD Stacy ləˑɑānz, some of the cars had chrome wheels, some had black. Well, since these aren't already chromed, and I'm going to be chroming other stuff, I have decided to go with black wheels on this ride. They're going to look fine, they're going to look lovely, and I don't get a chance to do black wheels on these stock cars very often, so it'll be a nice change with the white and red body and the gloss black wheels. So that's what I've decided to do there. The dashboard assembly, it's a nice long piece that just glues on from the bottom. I've got it with the wheel backs. We'll get this all painted, and then I will hand paint that aluminum faceplate on the dashboard. Don't forget your radiator line right there. You're all set to go on that tree. The spoiler, on every single one I saw was metallic color, so it's on its own tree. We'll get that painted up. What else we got here? This entire tree here of the parts we will be using, at least, the carburetor, the alternator, the air cleaner, the hood pins, the valve covers, and the radiator, and the shifter. The main color on those is a metallic or a chrome look. I've got some great chrome looking paint that you've seen before, and we'll be showing it in the painting section when it goes on. It looks like real bare metal, and I will be using that. Same as the headlights will be painted a silver tone, so we can push those into the body later. And when you paint things individually, it does look better than hand painting them later in a lot of cases. We've got the steering wheel, shocks, belt and pulley system, water bottle, fire extinguisher, radiator shroud, TV camera, and exhaust. This will all get primed with black, and then I will either hand paint or cut off and spray the little pieces individually at a later point to get them their specific colors. The hood is the same way. I cut off everything that I need to cut off. They say cut off the little hood hinges, and that will be ready to be sprayed on its tree. It's white plastic and white paint. I probably won't need to touch it up, but if I do, spritz a little bit of the white in a can and touch up where we're going to cut the sprue off. We're ready to go on the hood, and it can be held by my paint holders. The chassis, as always, is a beautiful work of art in design. I've got the rear end placed in there so I can line up the springs and everything and the supports, but that gets pulled off so I can paint that separately. Once the model glue dries, now I can clip onto that, get that painted its individual color and detailed, and put it together during final assembly. The chassis itself, you can get all the roll cage parts in, the fuel tank if you're not going to be building an open trunk. You got your front suspension ready to go. Just clean up any of that flash we saw on the roll cage as much as you want to, and then glue your firewall in. And that's how I like to get mine ready for paint, is that whole assembly, which according to the decal sheet should be red. So that'll be easy enough. We'll get that painted, get that red colored, and we're all set to go. The body, the nose piece, the rear bumper go on very nicely. When you're cutting off the cross braces underneath the hood, do not cut off these little nibs that you'll see on either side of the hood. That holds your hood up. If you're clipping those off thinking they're excess sprue, they are not. They are there to hold your hood, so don't slice them off. But you can see that body now. Looks awesome. I love how they key. The rear bumper keys in with these large tabs and a long solid piece. The front clip does the exact same. tabs on either side, and the long clip fits over there. Just test fit your hood, make sure it all lines up, and we are ready to go. Got the seat glued together. That will get painted up with the black parts. And the engine on this one, I want to do the entire engine in metallic. So we'll just have to get some black primer on it for shadows and get it painted up in color. I'm going to head over to the paint booth, which literally is to my left, and I'll see you there in just a second. Welcome back. After that little detail session, we've got a lot of the car ready to go. You can see that cool underbody with the detail on there, the light mist of the colonial red, the dark red. We got our shocks on there with the multicolor. They look awesome underneath. We got our roll cage all painted up. We got our interior glued together with our fire extinguisher and shifter and pedals and seat and everything inside, and the underhood area with our firewall. That's going to look nice. That's been going together. I have to press in the dashboard that I did with the aluminum face on it and put the nice decals in from the decal sheet with a little bit of solvent, and they soak right into those plastic molded details for the gauges. So those look awesome on there. We've got our black top to that. Our radiator is ready to go. That'll be the side you see. This is the back side. That's why I didn't do much of a wash inside of it. That's all going to be hidden. That's a nice looking unit with that chrome paint. We got our headers. You can see how nice they look. They will go on the engine from underneath when I get the engine placed in the chassis. It's near impossible to get them on the engine and then push it down in, so we put these on later. That white over the black gives them that nice coated look to them. They look nice and tough. The exhaust pipe itself I did with a hammered silver tone. And that's awesome. Hammered is just the name of the paint by Rust-Oleum. It's got that dimpled look to it. The steering wheel, of course, is ready. The air cleaner, I just used a little bit of buttercream paint for the element. We'll put that on there. Hopefully this time I'll remember to put it on the right way around. Doesn't matter because I just set it loosely on there. The wheel and tire package, you saw me assemble those. That looks awesome. I like the black in there. I don't get a chance to do black wheels very often on these cars. They're usually chrome. Got our radiator line there. Got that small block V8 assembled. All metallic on this one. Metal over the black with some black craft paint details. The belt and pulley system with the alternator. The carburetor, then I black washed. I lost one of the breathers, so this is going to be a single breather car. I just tinted the inside of the whole black. That'll be good enough on this one. So it looks nice. Excellent detail. You got the contrast of the raw metal to the aluminum paint. I like how that looks. We're all set to go. And then the body is all ready to go. I glued in the hood pins right away so that the super glue would have time to dry. I glued on the spoiler so that that would have time to dry correctly. And then I installed the glass like you saw. That is all set to go. The glass goes in there lovely. Looks good. Fits well, did all of our trim work, and it is now a live nude stock car. So all I have to do is press things together. There are different versions of the decals on there. So if you want to do the version that I want, is the one on the actual box or on the actual sheet that comes with the decals from Model Roundup, then I'll be doing it up that way. But you can do it with the JD Stacy. You can do it with the Stacy Pack Vitamins. You can do it with the Deep Blue Shadows, or you can do the regular JD Stacy, and we've got our striping and our contingency decals and everything to go on. So I'm going to get to that. That should take about an hour, maybe hour and a half, and then we'll let it dry. Be back for the final. Another Salvinos JR Models stock car build, and another pleasurable, easy fit build. In fact, my opinion on this ləˑmɑːnz, with the way it's been done by Jim over there at Salvinos, and the glass and everything, this is the best fitting body I've seen come out yet. The glass drops in, there's no gaps in the back, there's no, the side glass just pops in with a little bit of Mod Podge. It's seamless, it looks beautiful. I really like this. I think this would make a beautiful first glue kit for anyone. Or if you have someone that's been out of the hobby for a long time, I think something like this would be really, really awesome to give them. Because of this new ləˑmɑːnz body goes together so nicely, they can get some experience gluing things together. That old style monogram chassis inside goes together nicely. The tires and wheel package push together. The wheels just snap onto the chassis. It makes for a really, really nice model that anyone that is a NASCAR enthusiast could build without any trouble whatsoever. I love the fit of that glass design on there. I'm going to say that again. Sometimes they can be a little difficult to glue in or leave a little bit of a gap. You'll see me or him talk about that, some of the other ones. This one, it just all pushes right in. Use a little Mod Podge, hold it in place, or clear parts cement, whatever you like. You're not going to have a problem. The JD Stacy decals from Model Roundup, the power slide decals, go on really nice. I let them sit overnight in this case because I wanted them to conform to everything, the creases in the body and all that. And then I brushed two coats of future floor polish over the top of the car and the glass and everything from front to back, save for the tires, so that it looks nice and shiny like a race car does on its first day. The engine is highly detailed. We've got all kinds of detail underneath the chassis and everything. So it is an excellent kit and an easy build. These are available right now. I will link to where they are on the Model Roundup website. They also have more than just the Stacy decals. I picked those because I wanted the first 200 mile per hour qualifying lap car, and I found out about that, and I'm like, yeah, that, you know, and it's an easy build. It's a one coat paint job, and the decals do all the rest for you. So again, super easy model to build, easy to decal. Those power side decals through Model Roundup, they just go on so nicely and conform down. If you use a little decal solvent, they'll wrap under the fender, they'll wrap over the door panels, they'll go across the hood bumps and everything and settle down easily. Thanks as always for watching the workshop. We'll slow down a little bit. This is always fun to build these, and I hope to see many more. I wish them years of success. We thank Model Roundup for sending this over. We thank all of you for watching the channel. Buy a stock car, build it up, have a good time, and build the one that you want to see, because as always, build for you and no one else. Again, links in description where you can snatch up the kit and see the decals. There are some skull decals for the ləˑmɑːnz, and it was a hard choice for me to pick one, but I went with the JD Stacy. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.